resistors in series and parallel connection. A continuous conducting path consisting of wires and other resistances and a switch between the two terminals of a cell or a battery is known as electric circuit. In a series connection, electrical components are arranged in sequence and connected to one another in the closed circuit, whereas in the parallel connection, electrical components are arranged parallel to each other such that each component forms a branch of the circuit. Resistors can also be combined in two ways, in series and in parallel. When two or more resistances are connected end to end, consequently, they are said to be connected in series. And when resistances are connected between the same two points, they are said to be connected in parallel. Apart from potential difference, current in a circuit depends on resistance of the circuit. So, in the electrical circuits of radio, television, and other similar things, it is usually necessary to combine two or more resistances to get the required current in the circuit. Come on, let's learn to calculate the equivalent resistance when they are connected in series or in parallel. So, as discussed, in a series connection, resistances are connected end to end consequently. In this figure, there are three resistances R1, R2 and R3 connected in series. As there is only a single path for the current to flow, same current flows through all the resistors. But in a series combination of resistors, the total potential difference across the combination will be equal to the sum of the potential difference across the individual resistors. According to Ohm's law, we know that V is equal to IR. That means the potential difference V1 across R1 will be IR1, and V2 across R2 will be IR2, and V3 across R3 will be IR3. To find the total potential difference, let us add up V1, V2 and V3. So total potential difference V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. So it will become V is equal to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. Now V, the total potential difference, will be equal to the total current into total resistance in the circuit, which is I into RS. So IRS, where RS is the equivalent resistance in the series connection, will be equal to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. So we get the answer as RS, or the equivalent resistance in series connection, as R1 plus R2 plus R3. So, in a series combination of resistors, the equivalent resistance of the combination will be equal to the sum of the individual resistances. Three resistors of 10 ohm, 20 ohm and 30 ohm are connected in series. What is the equivalent resistance of the combination? We know that if resistors are connected in series connection, we have to just add up the individual resistances. So, the answer is 60 ohm. How will you find the potential difference across each resistor? In order to find the potential difference across each resistor, we first need to know the value of the current. So current I is equal to V divided by the total equivalent resistance. So you get the answer as 0.2 ampere. Now find out V1 using Ohm's law equation. V1 is equal to IR1. You get the answer as 2 volt, V2 as 4 volt and V3 as 6 volt. How will we make sure whether our answers are correct? Just add up V1, V2 and V3 and check with the total voltage given in the diagram. Isn't this easy, children? Now let's understand more about resistors in series. So, in series connection, the current is same throughout the circuit, but the potential difference across each resistors will be different, and hence the total potential difference will be the sum of the potential difference across each resistors. Equivalent resistance is obtained by adding up all the individual resistors in the circuit. And equivalent resistance in the circuit will be always greater than the individual resistance. Hence, this shows that when you connect resistors in series, then the effective resistance of the circuit increases. And if there are n resistors of same resistance value R connected in series, then the total resistance R will be n into R. Now, in series connection, it is not possible to separately switch on and off each appliance or component, and hence we cannot use that in a domestic circuit. The small LED fancy bulbs that we use for decoration is an example for series combination of resistors. Now let's understand what may happen when resistors are connected in parallel. In the parallel connection, the current splits at each junction. The total current in the circuit will be the sum of the separate current passing through each resistors, but the potential difference across each resistor will be same. So in a parallel connection, we'll have to find the total current using the formula I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3, because in this circuit you have three resistances. So according to Ohm's law, we have V is equal to IR and I is equal to V by R. Therefore, I1 will be V by R1, I2 will be V by R2, and I3 will be V by R3. Now, let's find the total current. So, I is equal to V by R1 plus V by R2 plus V by R3. Now, I will be the total potential difference divided by the total resistance in the circuit. That is V by RP. So, eliminating the common factor, we get the equation as 1 by RP is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This means that in a parallel connection, the sum of reciprocal of the individual resistances is equal to the reciprocal of the equivalent resistance of the combination. Now, let's find the equivalent resistance in the given circuit. So, 1 by RP is equal to 1 by 10 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 1. Simplifying the fraction, we get the answer as RP, which is equal to 20 by 32, that is 0.625 ohm. In order to find the total current in the circuit, first we have to find the individual current. So let us find out I2. I2 is V by R2, that is 4.5 ampere. Similarly, find I1 and I3 and sum of the individual current to get the total current. So let's summarize. In a parallel connection, the potential difference is same across each resistor. Total current is the sum of the individual current through various resistors. Sum of the reciprocal of individual resistances is equal to the reciprocal of the equivalent resistance of the parallel combination. In a parallel connection, equivalent resistance is always less than the individual resistance. If there are only two resistances in the circuit, then RP is given by R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. The advantage in a parallel connection is that we can separately switch off and on various gadgets in a parallel system, and hence this type of connection is preferably used in domestic connection. So let's compare a series and a parallel circuit. In a series circuit, the voltage is the sum of the individual voltage or potential difference across each resistors or component, whereas in a parallel combination, voltage is same. In series combination, current is same throughout the circuit, but in a parallel combination, you have to find the individual current through each resistors. The equivalent resistance is given by R1 plus R2 plus R3 in a series combination, whereas you have to take the reciprocal and find the resistance in a parallel combination. The figures shown here gives you a clear idea of the advantage and disadvantage of the series and parallel connection. Here is a homework for you children. Find out the equivalent resistance in each of these circuit, as well as the total current flowing in the parallel connection and the potential difference across R2 and R4 in the series connection. Compare both the circuits, which one is better? Which circuit will give you minimum current and maximum resistance, and which circuit will give you maximum current and minimum resistance? The answers are given in the description, but make sure that you first try out and then check the answer. Thank you for watching the video. If you have understood the concept of series and parallel resistance, then don't forget to like the video, share the video among your friends and family, and subscribe the channel for more videos of class 8, 9, 10 science.